On this International Peace Day, I invite you to celebrate the 50th anniversary of the NGO Committee on the Status of Women, Geneva. Over these five decades, the NGO Committee on the Status of Women, Geneva has been a beacon of hope, a powerhouse of advocacy, and a catalyst for change. For 50 years, we are advocating for women's and girls' rights, convinced that gender equality is a basic precondition for peace and fairness in the world. Our member organizations, all accredited at the United Nations Economic and Social Councils, share a vision of improving the lives of women and girls so they can realize their individual and collective potential. Please, Caroline, the floor is yours.
Less than 2 years after our committee was launched, our members went to Mexico City to attend the first World Conference on Women in 1975. This was the first global dialogue on gender equality. Three objectives were identified, three objectives that we are still working on. Elimination of discrimination, participation of women in development, and women's contribution in leadership to peace. A thoughtful thanks and appreciation to all those icons and pillars, not only of the women's movement, but more broadly of a global peace movement, those who have passed and those who are still fighting here, including those men who are rooting for us. It is the vision we share for transforming our world. The will, the solidarity, the humanity, ultimately the friendship among us.
Il reste encore de très nombreuses luttes à mener pour atteindre une égalité de fait entre les femmes et les hommes. Le droit des femmes à disposer de leur corps, à accéder à la contraception ou à l'avortement sont remis en question, et cela même dans les grandes démocraties que l'on croyait à l'abri de tels retours en arrière. L'accès au travail sans discrimination par rapport aux hommes et à un salaire équitable et équivalent, la possibilité pour une jeune fille de prétendre à la même éducation et aux mêmes opportunités professionnelles qu'un garçon, tout cela reste encore des combats à poursuivre. Une pensée particulière pour les femmes afghanes qui ont été déchues de leur totalité ou quasi-totalité de leurs droits, ainsi que pour les femmes iraniennes qui font face à la violence inouïe de leur gouvernement. Ils pourraient certes être décourageant de voir de nombreux défis s'ajouter à ceux déjà importants et combattus ces 50 dernières années, on peut toutefois se réjouir que des organisations telles que la vôtre existent pour relayer ces luttes efficacement auprès des Nations Unies. Soyez-en remerciés.
I was always impressed to see your member organizations stepping up to contribute to pushing for and indeed assisting the social partners who are the natural ILO members along with the member states. So pushing for and getting involved in negotiations towards new international labor standards that empower women and girls. Last year, 2022, 110 parallel events were organized or co-organized by CSW NGO Geneva member organizations. That calls for an enormous convening power, not to mention organizational skills, but the trust, which I think was brought out by Carolyn, the trust that an organization like this can engender. Keep up the good work.
By championing women's participation within and beyond the United Nations, the NGO Committee on the Status of Women Geneva is carving out a path towards a more just, equal, and prosperous world. As you mark this major milestone, we celebrate your impact and partnership. Congratulations on your 50th anniversary. May the next 50 years bring ever greater momentum to your work empowering women everywhere. Warmest congratulations, Doreen Bogdan Martin. Thank you. Thank you.
We will now embark on a journey through time to honor a few of our trailblazers who have paved the way for progress, equality, and empowerment in the realm of women's rights, and of course, the CSW Geneva. These individuals and many others have left an indelible mark on the history of women's rights and gender equality, inspiring all of us to continue to pursue a more just and equitable world, and what a better day, International Day of Peace. Let us also be inspired to carry the torch forward and also to commit or recommit ourselves to shaping a brighter future for women and girls everywhere.
And she holds a position in various advisory and supervisory boards of NGOs committed to the human rights.
The law and the views of the committee, like the rulings by the European Court, have an enormously important part in changing structures in the state parties. The legal system is really a very good way of to change structures, and I think that human rights, it's a legal form, and we should hold states responsible and accountable for following the human rights. And there are international courts or committees or other institutions and organizations that have that role, and I think that we should really make them do that role.
My third panelist will be Zarin Henschwood. Please, Zarin.
Develop our knowledge of what the possibilities are. So how the UN works, what are the processes, when can we be involved in statements? So not to keep control of that information, but to share it widely and help each other as organizations know better how to use the system. Really take joy in the accomplishment of others and celebrate our diversity as much as possible and recognize that we only have strength in our voice when we're united. So we need to work, we need to continue to have this work and be as united as we can and as positive as we can. I think it's very easy to criticize, and there are many things that we can criticize, but what is lacking in the world is positivity and action, and all of us are activists in this room, so we just have to continue to be active and to make sure that our deeds are more than our words.
Thank you.
Adriana Quinones.
Most of those initiatives by civil society organizations that have now been taken to scale and have become flagship initiatives. So there's so much to be recognized. We work very closely with civil society. We have civil society advisory groups in every country and regional office, as well as at the global level. We have the Women, Peace and Humanitarian Fund providing direct funding to women human rights defenders and grassroots organizations. And I know the tensions refer to lack of funding being provided by the UN, bureaucratic hurdles, lack of space for participating actively, but UN Women is very committed to changing this reality via these kinds of mechanisms. As UN, we're not always creating the most innovative programming and solutions. You can, and we are here to take it to scale, to make it known, and to recognize it. Thank you very much for having me.
I came to CERN, which is a home, the cutting edge technology. We do leading research. Absolutely. It opened my eyes that when we talk about technology, when we talk about science, there are broad spectrum of needs, and also for us scientists, but also civil society, we need to have an understanding and a meeting of what we mean and what technology means for
all of us. But unfortunately, at the same time, it showed how unevenly distributed it is. And it could only be empowering and globally empowering if it's the right functionality, it's the right place, it's the right time, in the right form, and most importantly, it must be for everybody.
I think civil society should be prioritized in this process of re-globalization, rethinking, remodeling, or developing on the existing mechanisms. Civil society must be the voice. Civil society is the key to decision-making, inclusivity, and diversity, which is important. So thank you so much. And again, congratulations to all of us, I will say.
Knocking on doors, governments and UN entities, collaboration with UN entities, be visible, active, rethinking our positions, but most of all, together we get it done. Thank you very much.